We're going to create two forms, one portrait form and one landscape form. To each form, we're going to specify that each has an indicator region. We're also going to specify that each form has a title, and we'll call one portrait form and we'll call the other one landscape form. Now, using the UI builder, we're going to specify some controls on this form. We're going to specify three buttons on each, which are going to perform the start, stop, and reset functionalities of a progress bar which we're going to add. Using the simulator, we'll see how we can switch from the portrait form to the landscape form and back again. So now let's have a look at the code and see how we can achieve this. What we're going to do now, we're going to use the UI builder to create our two forms. What we're going to do, we're going to insert a new form into our project. So within our resource explorer, we need to right click and select insert resource. Now what the UI builder provides to us is a portrait form to which we can modify its properties and add controls. So if we select the form, in the lower region we see that we have properties associated with that form. So let's go ahead and amend some of its properties. Let's add a title. We'll add the title portrait form. Let's specify soft key text. So we'll set the left soft key to read OK and the right soft key to read back. Let's also specify that we want to have an indicator region. So as we can see, our form now has an indicator region, a title, and two soft keys. Let's now add some buttons to our form. So we select the button object and we simply click on our form where we want to place it. Now you can actually drag your button anywhere where you wish to place it on the form. So let's add two further buttons. By clicking and holding, we can actually resize the objects also. Okay, now let's add a progress bar. Now that we have the objects that we want, we need to specify properties for each. So we need to specify text for our buttons, and we also need to specify the range of our progress bar. So what we need to do now is go and create an additional form. This will be the widescreen form. Select form and do insert resource. Just like before, it provides another portrait form. If we select the form and then come to here and select landscape, so let's go ahead and add the same components, buttons, progress bar, and soft keys as we did before. So we have a portrait form and a landscape form, each with start, stop, and reset buttons, progress bar, and two soft keys. What we'll do now is see how this is implemented and constructed in the code. Right, let's have a look at our class definition for our progress bar example. As you can see here, we have a number of various namespaces. In particular, we're using the runtime namespace, which will provide to us the timer functionality which will be used to control the progress bar. As we can see here, we're inheriting from the following classes: application, form, action event listener, timer event listener, and orientation event listener. Let's have a look at how we can construct the forms we've created through the UI builder in our application. In our on-app initializing routine, what we're going to do is construct our portrait form. This is the form that will be presented to the user when the application starts. So what we're going to do is create a new form, and we're going to use our tool form pointer to point to this new form. To this form, we need to add an orientation listener, and we do that by calling the add orientation event listener and passing the this pointer. For the soft keys now, we need to specify an action event listener for each. On orientation changed. Now, as our form will initialize in portrait, the first orientation event we will receive will be landscape. So let's have a look and see what we will do in the landscape case. What we will do is set our orientation state variable to be false. False indicates landscape mode. We will now create a new form for the widescreen. We will construct this form from the ID provided to us within the UI builder. We have to add this form to our frame. Up until this point, our frame was only aware of one form, the portrait form. By executing this line, the frame now has two forms. We now have to specify that the wide form is the current form. And then following this, we use our track available current form to simply assign current form our track available to be that of the wide form. Having done this, we can simply call draw and show, and we will now be presented with an orientation change containing the new wide form. If we have the case where the widescreen form is the current form, on performing an orientation state change back to portrait, all we need to do is make the current form the portrait form. We don't need to remove the handle to the widescreen form. We simply need to make the portrait form the current form. So let's start our progress bar running. Now, as we can see, the progress bar is incrementing every second. We can at any time rotate the orientation and the progress bar keeps incrementing. We can stop it and we can restart it again. So there is our timer complete dialog. And then if we select either OK or back, this will have the effect of terminating the application.
We'll be bringing you a regular series of technical training videos and updates on the bada platform. So keep checking our website if you want to know more. Thanks for watching.